Drive with confidence. From routine service to complete engine repairs, you can trust the pros at A1 Quick Oil to get you back on the road safely. Drop it off or sit and wait in customer-friendly comfort. Behind Napa off Highway 51 North, give Bobby a call.
Here at A1, we don't work on cars, we fix them.
Well, School Board Member Joey Piazza got an education like the rest of us in school board finances here at the Kiwanis in Ponchatoula when Jeff McNeely, the new chief financial officer for the board, gave a pretty detailed recitation on finances with this tremendous business. I wonder how many people know that the school system is more than a quarter of a billion dollar enterprise.
Right, and you know, a lot of people don't quite understand when they look at a school, there's a lot of intricate pieces that go into making that school function, and a lot of it revolves around money. Mr. Jeff did an amazing job today, and as always since we've got to know him, on explaining how that money, one, enters into the classroom and where does it go outside of that point. He gave all of our members today a wonderful overview of the different type of fundings we get here in our school system. You get property tax, which actually a lot of people don't understand, is a very, very small percentage of the amount of money that we actually use in our operating budget here at the school system. A lot of the money comes from state and local funding. So a lot of our area is funded with things that don't primarily affect us firsthand on a property tax. Our sales tax we just passed not too long ago for competitive salaries also adds into that pie chart as well. But again, a lot of the things that you see on a daily basis on our campuses are funded outside of the parish. And he has done a very good job to try to make that very transparent to people, to make people understand that we're not hitting your pocket as hard as you think we're feeling it. Because I own property too. I'm one in a million to say, I don't want more money coming out of my pocket either. But at the end of the day, we are facing challenges in our school system that we haven't faced in probably decades with the growth that we're seeing in our parish. We got new subdivisions coming up daily. I got a call just the other day about a new one coming in LaRanja. And what people don't understand is, yes, that will bring revenue to the parish. And it is good to have growth. But when your infrastructure is not prepared, that's when we can run into a problem. I mean, look at Robert area. We knew that growth was coming. We've kind of stalled a little bit on that growth when it comes to building new homes because our schools can't handle that growth. We have teachers teaching in hallways because we don't have enough school buildings. So I'm very glad we have Mr. McNeely as our financial advisor. I think he's doing a wonderful job, and I can't wait to see where he does.
Well, one of the things he pointed out is how much construction is going on at various schools. And you mentioned overcrowding. At least we're doing something about it, but literally every school in Tangipahoa Parish is getting some work.
Yes, and I'm very proud of that. Phase one happened before I got on the board. There was some flaws that I personally had during the campaign with phase one, but it's things that were out of my control. It's out of the parish's control. It's been voted on. But if you look at these new buildings, they look fantastic. I had an opportunity to walk a lot of those campuses with some other board members where we're getting new additions and new wings. And I think it's going to be much needed for those areas. But what I want to focus on, Ken, is phase two. That is something that will have immediate contact through me on the board and other members on the board. We have to be more responsible with how we're spending funds and how we're building these additions. A good example is if you compare apple to apple, what we built at Ponchatoula High as opposed to what we built at, just say, Champ Cooper, the money value of that was much higher in Robert. If we're going to build things, and Mr. Jeff mentioned it today, it's other people's money we're spending. So we have to be very transparent with that money and cautious when we're spending something. So if we're going to build additions, I want to see additions that are going to last us through the test of time. We have had a problem in Tangipahoa, and not just this board, but other boards as well, where we worry about tomorrow. We worry about the next day. We got to start worrying about 10 years and 20 years. When they're building houses left and right over here, by the time you lay your head down to go to bed, three more houses are sold and three more families have moved in. We have to keep up with that growth. And that's going to require us to really be attacking our growth plan when we start building these new additions. So like in Robert, I would love to see a two or three story building instead of a single wing. It's going to give us longevity for those classrooms. And that's the kind of things we have to look at as a board member.
Well, again, with a budget that exceeds a quarter of a billion dollars annually, and most of it comes from state and federal funds, you've got to also be constantly seeking grants, seeking more of those funds. Because if you get a 10% increase in state funding just because you're better at the paperwork, that's millions of dollars.
Correct. And a matter of fact, we have another new member on our team for the Tangipahoa Parish School System, and that's Mr. Terry Villaruta. He's over our maintenance program now. So he's over all of the new construction and all of the maintenance program. And he has done a fantastic job of tracking down these funds that are just up for grabs right now through FEMA, through these little grants and stuff. So instead of it coming out of our pocket, instead of it having to come out of the taxpayers' budget or a budget for the actual school system, it's coming out of FEMA grants, it's coming out of federal funds to help with our infrastructure. So like new roofs, new drainage issues. He's trying to get that through a lot of programs outside of our budget, and that's highly important. So we have two really good guys that worry about how we're spending money.
What else do you want to share with us?
Man, I'm happy that, you know, I'm on the board. I'm very happy of the work that we have achieved so far as a board. I'm very excited because I get teachers and administration come up to us, and they're happy to see the progress that we've done so far. I look forward to the next 4 years and the progress we have. And all of the wonderful talents we have in our classrooms, and I am truly blessed, Ken. And so that's to everybody in Tangipahoa. Thank y'all again, and again, I can't wait to see where Tangipahoa goes from here.
You can't afford to be without your vehicle. Bobby and his team of professionals at A1 Quick Oil will get you back on the road fast and with the job done right. All technicians are 100% certified. Behind Napa off Highway 51 North, give Bobby a call.
Here at A1, we don't work on cars, we fix them.